Hello students, how are you all? So we proceed further with our discussion, and in this presentation I am going to discuss with you aphorism number 62 to 70. So before we proceed for our discussion, our usual procedure, we will do the brief revision. So till now we are discussing that homeopathy, in homeopathy we observe natural cures. So examples are given so many times by Dr. Hahnemann about what happens when two dissimilar diseases meet in nature. So dissimilar diseases never cures, they form complex disease, or they will suspend each other for certain time, or the second dissimilar disease may not run its course. So they never cure, this similar disease never cure, and it is not in nature that this similar disease will cure. The second aspect is the treatment part. So first aspect was disease part, and second aspect is the treatment part. So the kind of treatment we give is antipathy and homeopathy. So what happens in the antipathic treatment? Antipathy never cures, allopathy never cures. Why they never cure? What is the reason? They just act like a two dissimilar disease meeting in the patient. So patient's natural disease is met with the dissimilar disease produced by antipathic treatment, and it is observed in nature that they will never cure. So is the case for the treatment of the diseases, antipathy never cures. In addition to this, the disadvantages of antipathy are, it's given in large doses, it's given in the form of mixtures, and the doses may be hazardous. And secondary reactions observed are very severe, and there is no law. Okay, allopathy not based on any law, antipathy based on law of contraria. So it is not in nature that two dissimilar diseases will cure. So is the case, antipathic treatment will never cure. Now see what is happening in homeopathy. Stronger similar disease cures weaker disease. This is observed in nature. Stronger similar disease cures weaker disease. Stronger disease is fatal. It's not in our hands to invite stronger disease to remove the weaker. Now what Hahnemann is giving us the viewpoint is that although the in nature the when two similar disease meet, stronger removes weaker, but there is a disadvantage for this type of cure. And what is the disadvantage? That stronger disease is fatal. Then it's not in our hands to invite the stronger disease to remove the weaker. We already discussed this, that we can't wait for the and invite the stronger disease to attack upon us. In addition, they act conditionally. The same reason, it's not in our hands to suffer from the disease. Natural diseases is not an option to cure. So what is the option to cure is the homeopathy. So homeopathic medicines bring upon cure similar to natural disease. Artificial similar disease is produced by the homeopathic remedies. It is based on law of similars, which is the only method to cure. So two parts we have discussed is about the dissimilar diseases and similar diseases and mode of treatment, antipathy and homeopathy. So the underlined understanding you have to know is this, that it is not in nature that dissimilar diseases will cure, and it is in nature that similar disease cures. but that cannot be option to cure. So what is the only option to cure is the homeopathy, and thus homeopathy is natural science. It is based on law of similars. So that is what the discussion we have done up till now. Okay, so we shall proceed further. In aphorism number 62, Dr. Hahnemann confirms that Dr. Hahnemann was the first to perceive this fact through manifold observations. Dr. Hahnemann took number of cases and then he found that these observations he has noted, that what happens when two dissimilar diseases meet, what happens when two similar diseases meet. So homeopathy cures, not like palliation by antipathy. It is not a temporary relief to the patient. It's a cure. So cure is permanent. So the importance of the healing art must be understood. So the conclusion is this: homeopathy alone cures. And what are the basis for this? The basis is that it is observed in nature that stronger similar disease removes the weaker. So again, same discussion, same points are continued. Again and again, Dr. Hahnemann is emphasizing upon us his observations, his conclusions, and how he has correlated the homeopathic cures. Okay, so we go further. Again, aphorism number 63, very important, all of you know, it is describing primary action and secondary action. So what is primary action? Action of drug upon vital force is primary action. So what it is given? Every medicine deranges the vital force. Vital force reacts to this action is called as secondary action. So action of drug is primary action and reaction of vital force is the secondary action. Okay, so that's given in aphorism number 63. So we proceed further. What happens in primary action? Now during primary action, as it is the action of medicine upon the vital force is passive and medicines are active. What happens during secondary action? Vital force shows two types of actions. Vital force shows two types of actions. Secondary counteraction, which is exact opposite condition of health, is produced. That is seen in the antipathic type of treatment. Secondary curative action means similar superior power is generated to extinguish the disease. Secondary curative action is the similar superior power is generated to extinguish the disease. So in homeopathy, the curative action takes place, whereas in antipathy, secondary counteraction takes place. Okay, so primary action, vital force is passive. It receives the action of medicine. Whereas in secondary action, vital force shows two actions, counter action and curative action. Counter action is seen in antipathy and curative action is seen in homeopathy. So aphorism number 65, we proceed further. Again, the examples are described about primary action and secondary counteraction. See now, the example of hand first bathed in hot water gets warmer is primary action. Then it becomes more colder is secondary counteraction. Okay, a hand first bath in cold water is first pale, then it becomes more warmer. So this is secondary counteraction. Another example, see, in patient with sleeplessness, opium produces sleeps. Patient will sleep a lot. after taking opium. That is primary action. And following night, he becomes more sleepless. That is secondary action. So in secondary action, the patient is getting worse. Secondary action is more antagonistic, or it is called as counteraction. So in antipathic treatment, you will observe secondary counteraction. Okay, so you have already known this since first, second year, and we have just done the revision that in antipathy, we observe secondary counteraction. Okay, so we move further. Now, what is secondary curative action? The antagonistic secondary action is not seen in homeopathy because of its small dose and because the nature is of similimum. The nature is of similimum and it's a small dose. Small reaction is generated similar to the sufferings of the patient. Means what? After administration of the remedy, what happens? The reaction is generated similar to the sufferings of the patient. Hence, why it is so? Because it's similimum. So, similimum remedy will generate the similar complaints, similar sufferings. Okay, and thus what happens? It occupies the same organs which are having the dysfunctions. And as it occupies the same organs which are having dysfunctions, the patient no longer feels the action of the natural disease. And now he is under the action of the medicine. And as the dose is small, the action of the medicine disappears soon, leaving the patient free of his sufferings. So this is how the cure takes place. Okay, that is called as secondary curative action. What it is called as? Secondary curative action. So we move further with the aphorism number 67, where what is mentioned is suspended animation. What is mentioned? Suspended animation. So what is advised here by Dr. Hahnemann is the use of antipathic treatment is advised in which cases? In most urgent cases. So in most urgent cases, antipathy is advised. Patients with accidents, asphyxia, drowning, electric shocks. In such conditions, your physician can give antipathic mode of treatment. Is advisable by Dr. Hahnemann. These conditions of accidents, asphyxia, drowning is called as suspended animation. Animation means to impart life. Suspended means the vital force is in danger to be lost and it cannot give the life. That is animation. In such cases of drowning, asphyxia, accidents, Dr. Hahnemann advised us to give antipathic mode of treatment. Why it is given? Because homeopathic medicines have no time to act. Symptoms may disappear. Symptoms may disappear. So antipathy is required to save the patient. So coffee, application of heat, antidotes, surgical suturing of the arteries, everything is allowed in most urgent cases where vital force is suspended. This is called as suspended animation. Okay, so animation means what? To give life. Suspended means what? The vital force is in so much danger that it cannot give life in cases of accidents. Example is given, asphyxia, drowning and electric shock, where vital force is in danger to be lost. You always get a short note on suspended animation. So it is, you have to elaborate these points. So antipathy is advised by Dr. Hahnemann in such cases of accidents, asphyxia and drowning or electric shock. Okay, so you can give antipathy. So we go to the next aphorism. Homeopathic cure. So what is mentioned in 68? Homeopathic cure takes place due to its minute dose, due to similimum. We already saw in nature it takes place. Similar disease removes the weaker similar disease. Hence, the cure takes place due to similimum. But as compared to the natural disease, as the dose of homeopathic remedy is in our hands, it will disappear soon. So it is not like that the stronger similar disease in nature, it occupies the patient's different parts. Okay, and he is although relieved of his sufferings, the previous sufferings, the second sufferings are now, they start in the patient. Okay, so it is never the case with the help of similimum. So homeopathic cure takes place due to minimum dose, that is minute dose, a similimum which is stronger, a little stronger than the natural disease. Now what happens? The natural disease is removed, medicinal disease remains, soon disappears due to small dose. So medicinal disease is remaining, which will soon disappear due to small dose. Vital force has no need to react against this medicinal disease now present, because there is no necessity, it is automatically going to disappear as the it has got a limited action. So medicinal disease will soon disappear. Vital force has no need to react. Health is restored. What is done? Health is restored. Cure takes place. So previous morbid state is extinguished and patient is cured. So homeopathic cure takes place due to minute dose, due to its similarity. It is little stronger than the natural disease. Okay. Now what happens? After the administration of similimum, it produces artificial disease in the body and it will occupy all the same parts which are suffered due to natural disease. And now patient is under control of the action of similimum and not under the control of natural disease anymore. So this is how you have to explain how homeopathic cure takes place. So medicinal disease now soon disappears due to small dose. Vital force has no need to react because it is every phenomena is taking place automatically. So the medicinal disease also soon disappears and patient enjoys state of health. Health is restored and previous morbid state is extinguished. So this is given in aphorism number 68 about homeopathic cure. Okay. So we go to 69. Again, Dr. Hahnemann compares. He makes us sure that if you compare the antipathic mode of treatment and homeopathic mode of treatment, which is the best? And what are the disadvantages of antipathic treatment? That is discussed in aphorism number 69. And the use of antipathic treatment is discussed in the aphorism number 67. In the suspended animation. So in antipathy, physician administers the medicine which produces opposite effects to the disease. So in antipathy, what happens? Physician is administering the medicine which is producing opposite effects to the disease. So, for some time, the sufferings are not felt by vital force and patient feels better. So example, patient is having constipation, you give the medicine which produces diarrhea, patient is relieved of his constipation. Okay, so he's feeling better. Antagonistic or opposite symptoms does not occupy the symptoms of disease. Right? So this medicine which is opposite, it will not occupy the same symptoms of the disease. So patient of constipation is produced diarrhea by the action of medicine. Similimum occupies the symptoms of the disease. So vital force no longer feels the previous morbid symptoms, but only the symptoms of similimum. So we already discussed this point, what happens with the action of similimum. So what happens? Similimum occupies the symptoms of disease. So vital force no longer feels the sufferings, that is morbid symptoms. And now vital force is under the control of similimum. Thus, antipathy palliates and homeopathy cures. In antipathy, we observe secondary counteraction, whereas in homeopathy, we observe secondary curative action. Am I clear? Okay, so symptoms return in more intensity after the action of dose is over. Another disadvantage, antipathy palliates, it produces opposite symptoms, and after the first action, the primary action is over, the secondary counteraction takes place and symptoms return in more intensity. So again, a disadvantage of antipathy. Okay, so all of you know this, all these points. So we have refreshed it and we are very accurately understanding the various concepts of natural cures and treatments. So natural cures is in correlation with the homeopathic cure, whereas the dissimilar disease never cure and antipathy never cures. So two and two, four important points you will have to understand and remember. And the discussion is again and again done on these aspects of antipathy, homeopathy, natural cures, and what happens when two dissimilar diseases meet. Okay. So the last aphorism, that is aphorism number 70, inference, that is the conclusion. So aphorism number 70, till this aphorism, it's a theoretical part of Organon. Okay, so Dr. Hahnemann has given the introduction about homeopathy, how it is a natural science, and if you compare the homeopathic treatment with the antipathic treatment, what is the superiority of the homeopathic treatment, how the option of homeopathic treatment is always far superior than the natural cures. So these four points always are continuously mentioned and discussed in minute details. Okay. So what is the conclusion? See this, life principle maintains health. So aphorism number 9, which maintains or which discusses vital force. So this, what is disease and what is health? So health is what? Harmonious functioning of vital force. What is disease? It is derangement of vital force. So what happens in disease? The symptoms are produced. Symptoms are the one which are curable in disease. Which symptoms are curable? The general symptoms are always curable. So if you, when we go to the further discussions, you will understand the symptoms which are curable are the general symptoms, and automatically the particular symptoms start disappearing. So what is disease going giving rise to health is restoration of health. So homeopathic medicines bring back the state of health. Cure is possible only by simillimum. Cure is only possible by action of simillimum. Homeopathic medicines have power to produce same symptoms on healthy individual. So when we select the homeopathic remedy for the patient, when we already know that this medicine has produced same set of symptoms in healthy provers, okay? So then only we can match the simillimum and administer to the patient. Cure is brought by life principle. Cure is brought by life principle, that is your vital force. And that completes the aphorism number 70. That's the first part. So, my dear students, I'm going to take the orals on this aspect of the aphorisms. So, you will have to go through the presentations, learn it properly. If you have got any difficulty, you can ask me. So, before I conclude, what is health? It is a harmonious functioning of vital force. What is disease? It is a derangement of vital force. Disease is represented by symptoms. And homeopathic remedies bring back the state of health from the state of disease. Cure is possible only by simillimum. Cure is brought by action of life principle. So homeopathic medicines, the secondary curative action is produced and vital force is made free from sufferings of natural disease. So all of you must learn properly, and you can again and again study the slides which are made on revision. Okay, so all the theoretical points are well covered in the slides also, as well as I am giving you this narration so that your concepts are clear with each and every points which are discussed in the various aphorisms. Okay, so all the best and thank you.